Hi, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at audio clipping. We're going to use audio clipping as a simple form of distortion to add some extra richness and harmonics to our sounds. So we're going to start with a simple sine wave oscillator. We might set it at 220 Hz. As a default frequency. As always, we'll make sure we have a volume control for our oscillator. Use a number box to control that volume. Set its properties to range between 0 and 1. And then send that out to a digital to analog converter for our audio out. So now we should get our standard sine wave oscillator. What I want to do for this example is to introduce an additional gain control for the purposes of adding level and potentially distorting our output. Now, usually this is an undesirable feature, but we're going to be doing this deliberately in this particular video. So I'll add an additional gain here. So we turn this up slightly, turn that up. So now we've got, in a sense, two gains. So we'll move our audio up to full volume. And then with this gain, introduced by the audio system that I'm going through. What we can do is to control that clipping, we can introduce a new object called clip tilde object. It's tilde because it's an audio object, because we're going to clip audio in this case. The clip object takes two values. Its lowest value, minimum value, and the maximum value. And for audio, we want our audio signal, for example, to range from negative 1 to 1. So now when we go through here, this clip object is going to perform the clipping. So now what you can see is that even though our master volume is not at 100%, we're still getting this clipping, this as we exceed 100% volume. And that's because this clip object is doing that clipping for us even before the output. So this means that we can still control the volume level of our sound, and we can also control the amount of clipping. If you notice, if we just keep going, we're cutting off the top and the bottom parts of the sound until eventually we get something which looks very much like a square wave and has the sort of harmonic spectra not dissimilar to that. So in this case, we've sort of got a range between a single tone from our sine wave up to a square wave, almost the inverse of a filter in a sense, creating additional harmonics. You can see those harmonics appear in the spectrum analyzer as soon as we get over that threshold. It introduces a whole range of additional upper harmonics as a result of this clipping, which is effectively distorting the sound. All right, so that's all good and well. If we do this though to a more complex sound, actually I can leave the gain there. If I replace this oscillator with an analog to digital converter so that it's listening to the audio that's coming in, I've got this connected in this case to my microphone, turn that up slightly. You can see in the oscilloscope that as I talk, we get variation in the level. I know I need to increase this a little bit because my microphone's reasonably soft. There we go, he's starting to get some talking. And then our sound will also be clipped in a similar way as we were before. If we want to be able to control the clipping even more, what we might want to do is to control the level at which it clips. At the moment it's going from negative 1 to 1. But let's just say we instead want to have a control here where we can vary what that clipping level is. Then we can use this to control two aspects of it. There's the minimum and the maximum. The maximum is quite direct, we can just simply control that there, but if we want to have a minimum that's in the negative range, we're going to need to multiply that signal by negative 1 so that it becomes negative by the same amount, and then that can go in here. Now, as we if I increase this level, you can start to see that I'm distorting my sound. Our clip level now is lower than it was before, and you can clearly see that inside our oscilloscope. As we make this lower and lower, you can see we're clamping down on the level where the clipping is occurring, and so that also allows us to have some control over the amount of distortion, but we obviously need to balance that out with the overall volume and the gain. So there's a few gain stages that need to be managed to make this work, but this gives us a very straightforward process of creating some distortion on through clipping on any signal that's coming into the computer. See you in the next video.